Hello students, hope you all are doing well. Today we are going to start our unit number 6, that is industrial sector, or you can say tertiary sector. Then 2 marks questions from this unit. You are going to get 2 important questions. On board we have some 7 questions, and out of 7 2 marks, you are going to get 2 marks questions in your exam. So let us start with our first one, that is global market. Hope you have seen globe in your primary classes. So it consists of the whole world. So global market, in the sense we need to expand our market through worldwide. That is the simple meaning. According to economics, what is the definition? Let us see. Global market means introducing economy. Economy means a country. Introducing economy to international competition. Now there are various kinds of competitions, like domestic competition and national competition. Then the final step is international competition. So the highest level is international competition. We were at domestic competition. Now we need to improve our standard, not to national but to international level. So we need to introduce our economy to international competition. And what is the actual meaning of global market? It is an international market of all goods and services. It is an international market, means the buying and selling of products will be done with foreign countries. So a global market is nothing but international market for all goods and services. We were having our business at a small level, that is called the domestic level. Now we need to improve it. We need to increase our market. We need to expand our market through worldwide countries. That is nothing but international market of goods and services is called as a global market. The second question is Make in India. It is one of a kind of program, that is Make in India. It was initiated to improve the Indian economic growth. Now, till then we have been focusing on the growth of other countries. Now it's time for India to develop itself, to have a growth in its market, etc. So now it's time to make India a developed country. So because of this reason, this program have been initiated to improve Indian economic growth. And this program is implemented not only for overseas but also for domestic. Means it was not only for international countries, but it is focusing on our own domestic countries. For example, if I want to improve someone, first I need to improve myself. Am I right? So in the same way, if I want to improve the foreign countries, then first I need to improve my own country. So this program is implemented not only to overseas, means foreign countries, but also to the domestic. So it have been established industries not only for overseas but also in domestic. The second concept is the industries are established in India rather than in other countries. Means whatever the domestic companies are there, they need to establish their industries in India but not in other countries, because the term Make in India means we want to develop our country India. So companies should establish industries in India, not in other countries. Let us go to the third one, that is SIDBI, Small Industries Development Bank of India. Small Industries Development Bank of India. The word itself is saying that we need to develop the small industries. So this have been started on April 2nd, 1990. When SIDBI have been started? It have been started on April 2nd, 1990, with an objective to develop as well as to expand the small scale industry. As you know that there are various kinds of industries, small industries, tiny industries, cottage industries, large industries, mega industries. So apart from, or you can say among all these industries, we are focusing on the development and expansion of which industry? Small scale industry. And it provides finance, marketing and technical assistance to small scale industries. So this should be, this Small Industries Development Bank of India is providing finance. Finance in the sense it is related with money, or you can say capital. So it is providing finance and it is also helps in marketing. Means your products advertisement is also necessary. Customers should have knowledge about your product. So who is helping in the marketing and advertisement of SSI? SIDB. Then the last one is, it also provides technical assistance. Whatever technological machinery assistance or help is required, that is also provided by Small Industries Development Bank of India. Just keep one thing in mind, its objective, its main aim is to develop as well as expand the small scale industries. The next concept is SSI. That is again nothing but small scale industry. Is an industry in which the capital investment is more than 1 crore, but the limit have been kept only for 3 crores. Means the industries in which the capital investment, means the total investment, should be more than 1 crore, but it should not exceed 3 crores, then it is termed as a small scale industry. Number 5, IPR 1956. The full form of IPR is Industrial Policy Resolution. The full form of IPR is Industrial Policy Resolution 1956. So this have been announced. This policy have been announced by the government of India. Now let us see what are its objective. The first objective is to increase rate of growth. Is to increase the rate of growth. Rate of growth of whom? Industries. Through industrialization process. Means we need to transform from agriculture sector to industrial sector. That is nothing but industrialization. So how we can increase the growth of industries? Only through industrialization process. The second objective of IPR 1956 is mutual cooperation between public and private sector. That means there must be mutual understanding, mutual cooperation between the two sectors, that is public sector and private sector. The third objective of IPR 1956 is to develop dash and dash industries. There are two industries which IPR 1956 wants to develop. Those industries are heavy industries and machine industries, like steel, heavy steel limited will be there. So such kind of heavy machinery industries need to be developed as per IPR 1956. The last objective is to establish socialistic pattern. Socialistic pattern means we should not see your private profit, but you should work on social gain. Means I shouldn't be selfish, I should not see my own profit, but I should see the benefit of each and every person in the country. That is nothing but socialistic pattern. So according to IPR 1956, we need to establish socialistic pattern. There are 4 objectives. First, we need to increase the rate of growth. How? By industrialization process. And mutual cooperation must be there between public and private sectors. Then we need to develop heavy as well as machine industries. Then also we need to establish socialistic pattern of society. These are the four objectives of IPR 1956 which have been announced by the government of India. The sixth definition is industrial finance. Finance means the amount which is required to start an industry. So the amount of funds or finance which are required by an industry to perform its production process. For example, like production means you require raw material, you require inputs, you require machinery, you require labor, you require electricity. There are many things which you require in production process. So if I want to conduct all those operations, I require finance. So whatever funds or whatever the amount of finance which is required by an industry to perform its production functions or production processes are known as industrial finance. It is like a food. It is like a life and blood of industries. Without finance, industries will never exist. Like without food, without oxygen, without blood in our body, can we survive? No. In the same way, without finance, industries also cannot survive. So they require finance to perform their production processes. For example, my function is to give an explanation on this topic. If I don't have enough capacity, if I don't have enough energy and strength, then could I explain all these topics easily for you? No. So that means this is much important for me. What is much important? Food is much important. Oxygen is much important. Blood in my body is important. Without these things, my body is not going to function. In the same way, for industries, the life and blood is their finance. Without finance, they cannot perform their production process. The last one is public sectors and private sectors. The term public, whenever you hear, you need to link in your mind that public means it is related with government. Whenever private means it is related to private individuals. Now public sectors are owned, managed and controlled by government. That means the owner of public sector is government. And the person who is managing all operation is also government. The person who is controlling all the operations is also the government. So, private sectors are owned, managed and controlled by government. Now, what are the examples? ONGC, that means Oil and Gas Corporation. Then BHEL. That is nothing but Bharat Heavy Electronics Limited. Then BSNL, Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited. These are all private sector companies. ONGC, BHEL, BSNL, etc. Now let us see what are private sectors. These are owned and controlled by private individual or firms. The private people, private persons or private firms will be having the ownership of this private sector. What are the examples? ITC Limited, that means Imperial Tobacco Company Limited. Then ICICI Bank Limited, that means Investment Credit Industrial Corporation of India. This is the full form of ICICI. So ICICI Bank and ITC Limited are the examples of private sector. So we have completed nearly seven definitions. Last one time, let us recall it. What is global market? It means international market of goods and services. What is Make India concept? It is nothing but to establish industries in India, not in other countries. To establish industries in India, not in other countries. Then, SIDBI, its main objective is to develop as well as to expand small-scale industries. Then what is SSI? Whose capital investment should be more than 1 crore, but it should not be more than 3 crores. So the limit is kept as 3 crores. Then IPR 1956, this was announced by the government of India and it have four objectives. First, to increase rate of growth. second, to have mutual cooperation. Third, to develop heavy industries and machine industries. Fourth is to establish socialistic pattern. Socialistic means not private gain, but public gain. Everyone should get the advantage, not only yourself. Then industrial finance. It is nothing but whatever finance which is required by an industry to perform its production processes. Then public sectors are owned, managed and controlled by government only. Private sectors are owned, managed and controlled by private individuals or private firms. Examples are ONGC, BHEL, BSNL. Examples of private is ITC and ICICI Bank. Hope all these seven definitions are understood by you. Please note it down in your books, write for 5 times and practice and learn it for at least 10 times. Read each definition, each line for 10 times and practice it for 5 times. See you in the next classes with some more and interesting topics. Till that, stay home, stay safe and always keep practicing.